Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. From the moment we're born until well into our adult years, we're constantly being told what we should be protecting our bodies from. We're told to get vaccinated, to use bug repellent, to stay away from certain countries, to remove ticks immediately, to use protection. And why? Because we're all afraid of dying from a weird virus, of course. However, it is true that there are a lot of viruses out there we've never heard of and are oblivious to being scared of, which is exactly why we're going to talk about them today. Here are the top 10 weird viruses you've never heard of. But before we get started, why not become an archivist today by clicking that subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss out on any future uploads. If you end up enjoying this video, let us know by giving it a thumbs up. And in the comment section, invent your own virus and tell us what the symptoms would be. Number 10. Rotavirus. Rotavirus is a rampant virus in children that causes the small intestine to release water into the gut, causing diarrhea, dehydration, and more devastating symptoms. By age 5, almost all children have been infected at least once. It's pretty small and travels through the fecal-oral route. Even just a little bit of contamination will get you, and as a result, all of your friends too. There are 8 species, all very alike. The interesting thing is that every time you get it, you become a little more immune, so it affects you less next time. This isn't one of those diseases that you get only in underdeveloped countries either. It can travel in clean water supplies, which makes it easy to live and spread in developed countries. The best way to prevent it? Vaccines. Not just injections either, in case you or your kids are afraid of needles. Oral vaccines are available, and they've resulted in a decrease of over 50% of cases. Number 9. Cytomegalovirus. This is a sexually transmitted infection which is, though you've never heard of it, actually quite common. Planned Parenthood said that about 80% of the US population carries it, and 4 in 10 Americans are infected before puberty. Why? Teen sex? No. Well, maybe. But also because it also spreads through saliva and other bodily fluids. You can never get rid of it either. So why isn't everyone talking about it? Because it's mostly symptomatic, sometimes showing up as a rash or a cold. It doesn't pose a risk for most, unless you're pregnant or have a compromised immune system. If you do show more severe symptoms, they'll probably be fever, pneumonia, diarrhea, ulcers, hepatitis, encephalitis, behavioral changes, seizures, coma, visual impairment. But again, highly unlikely. You'll probably just get mononucleosis at the very worst. Number 8. Henipavirus. A 3-in-1 virus for you at number 8. This includes Nipavirus, Cedarvirus, and Hendravirus, which are all prevalent in African, Asian, and Australian bats. It's caused outbreaks in Australian horse populations and fruit bats, which somehow end up affecting humans as well. Usually, it was contracted via the horses by the handlers. There's not like a weird bat cult in Australia, though if there is, please tell us about it. As a result of this virus, 45 horses and 7 humans died. And now the notoriously strict Australian government vaccinates all horses against Hendravirus to protect them and their handlers. The Nipah strand is carried by a fruit bat in Asia and has been much more lethal, killing almost 300 people and affecting hundreds of thousands of livestock. It has flu-like symptoms which cause organ failure and has no vaccine. Fun fact, it was actually the inspiration for the virus in the movie Contagion. So far, they're not a great threat, but if human-to-human transmission happened, since we have no vaccine, we'd have a large problem on our hands. Number 7. Lymphogranuloma Venereum. Nope, this virus won't make your pen float in midair above your wizardry book. It will actually cause bumps, ulcers, fever, chills, muscle and joint pain, swollen glands, and eventually hemorrhoid growths, swelling of the reproductive organs, and rectal ulcers that require surgery. Ow, 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 ow. I know what you're thinking. Oh, how can I avoid this virus, Jim? Well, it's a sexually transmitted infection common in Central and South America, though not absent in North America. So watch out. Use protection, and if you do happen to get infected, worry not. Go straight to your doctor and tell her to attack that sucker with antibiotics. That'll do the trick. Just make sure you do it between stages 1 and 2, when the symptoms are still somewhat tolerable. Number 6. Human T-cell lymphotropic virus. Another sexually transmitted virus. This one is the same class as the HIV/AIDS virus endemic in places like Japan, the Caribbean, Central and South America, West Africa, and southeastern US. Why the southeastern? What are you guys doing over there? You know what? Don't answer that. You can transmit it via sexual contact, exposure to contaminated blood, and breastfeeding. As with HIV, no vaccines exist, nor any prospects for them are coming soon. After you contract the virus, it lives in your body for a really long time, not manifesting until later in life. In severe cases, it causes neurological diseases, inflammation of the eyes, and rheumatic syndromes. Those all sound like great reasons to stay healthy, get tested regularly, and protect yourself, am I right? Number 5. Intestinal parasites. Parasites? You've heard of parasites, right? Well, not like this, you haven't. These parasites are spread through sexual contact. There are a wide variety of ways of getting these, but we'll let you use your imagination on those. But mainly it's because of sexual practices that involve getting up close and personal with someone's, back door. As a result, you'll find conditions like giardiasis, amebiasis, and cryptosporidiasis that show symptoms as simple as pain to bloody diarrhea and intestinal cysts. Ouch! Number 4. Vaccinia. This DNA virus was previously used as a vaccine to eradicate smallpox, which actually happened, so humanity won, Vaccinia zero. A man named Edward Jenner used a cowpox virus to vaccinate people against smallpox for 182 years until the disease was gone altogether. Since they didn't keep great records, we don't really know how Vaccinia originated, and since its origin, the virus has changed from regular cowpox. It was the first of the live virus vaccines to be used on people, so it's modern as far as medicine goes. People show fever, rash, and among those who suffer from skin allergies or eczema, the disease can spread across the whole skin. It can also go after your organs, cause skin lesions, ulceration, necrosis, and encephalitis. It's not often used now, except on U.S. Army personnel, to prevent a bioterror attack involving smallpox. Number 3. Donovanosis. Donovanosis is the unfortunate culprit behind, brace yourself, chronic genital ulcers. Now, don't worry, since antibiotics have been around, Donovanosis is pretty rare, which is probably why you haven't heard of it. However, Australia and South Africa have seen recent surges. Though the scariest parts may seem to be the genital symptoms, infections also affect areas on your face and chest. All symptoms and types of the virus basically include ulcers of some kind. Fleshy red ones, dry ones, foul-smelling ones with tissue damage, or dry ones with scar tissue. Hey, you're welcome for the visuals. Number 2. Parainfluenza Virus. Hey, the paraflu. I don't think anyone actually calls it that. It's mostly associated with swelling of the throat with a bark-like cough. Is not that the most picturesque simile? Sometimes it also causes bronchitis and pneumonia. This virus hardly ever takes lives, only truly affecting those with immune deficiencies, but children and the elderly often suffer from it, so it's quite a burden on the healthcare system. In the US alone, e-virus is said to cost $200 million per year. Severe cases can be treated with a general antiviral called ribavirin, but hopefully soon we'll see a vaccine. Number 1. Ramsay-Hunt Syndrome. The Ramsay-Hunt syndrome has one of the scariest faces of common nerve damage. Literally, it causes facial nerve paralysis. Half of the people who suffer from it don't get treatment in time, which can lead to permanent facial disability. The fact is, the virus acts a whole lot like Bell's palsy, suffered by people like Angelina Jolie and George Clooney. Part of the face drops and suddenly you can't eat, smile, or blink. All of this happens within hours. With Ramsay-Hunt syndrome, unlike Bell's palsy, the cause is simple. Shingles are the culprit, going after the facial nerve located in your cheek near your ear and jawline. Though shingles sound like something people don't get anymore, if you've had chickenpox, you can get shingles. So, what do you do? Get off WebMD and go to the doctor. They'll prescribe the antivirals you need and a set of steroids to send you on your way to recovery. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe, click the notifications bell so you'll know when we upload new videos, give this video a like, and leave a comment below about which one of these viruses you'd least want to get.